story. This is the story of Gordy and the impossible situation. So, on this particular day, Daddy, Mommy, Gordy, and Baby Melody were out in the mountains hiking around. And that was one of Gordy's favorite places to be. It was the second favorite place to the beach. He loved going to the beach and looking for shells. But Gordy also loved picking up pine cones to paint and weaving pine needles into little baskets and looking for pretty stones to paint and all sorts of other things. Gordy liked the forest because of all the cool looking bugs he could find. They were all different shapes, colors, and sizes.
Bananas, if there are any banana trees.
No, there's no bananas in the forest where they were. Bananas grow in tropical places.
Oh, in the woods.
This is just a very cold, crisp, rocky mountain forest. Now, on this day, they had a forest trail that they were hiking up, and lots of trees were around. Mommy had brought a little snack, but they had hiked a long, long time, and they were tired, and they were getting really hungry. And Mommy said, oh dear, I didn't think we were going to be hiking around this much. We've been having so much fun, we haven't even looked at our clocks. Look what time it is. We've been out here for hours playing and having fun. They were really tired. They hiked back down the trail and came to the car, and Mommy was thinking, well, we're going to have to go drive all the way home, and then I'll have to start some food straight away. I thought we would be back long before lunchtime, but this ended up being an all-day family adventure. Gordy said, well, why don't we just pray that God gives us a picnic? Daddy laughed and said, well, that would be nice, wouldn't it? We could just sit here and eat next to the car and then do some more walking because we really love it. But God's picnic is going to have to hurry up and come pretty quickly because we need to eat. And if it doesn't show up, we have to drive a long way to get home. What do you mean, said Gordy. Come on, let's pray for a picnic. We need to pray. God's not going to do anything if we don't pray for one.
Gordy was
very serious, and he wanted a picnic, and he was absolutely sure that God could give them a picnic. He didn't know how, but he was sure that it could happen.
God can do anything.
Yep. So they waited. Gordy's daddy said, okay, 10 minutes. We'll pray for 10 minutes, and if God's picnic doesn't show up, then we have to drive home and have some food. They prayed for 10 minutes and sang songs and thanked God for the lovely day that they'd had, but they didn't see any picnic. Gordy was so disappointed because he was sure God would answer them and give them a picnic.
Maybe God was just thinking Gordy thoughts and he'd do it another day.
Come on, Gordy, let's go. Time to get in the car. Gordy didn't say much of anything. He was just thinking so hard. And he was looking at the mountains as they started driving. It was a very high mountain road, and they had to go very slow on it because it was windy and it was small road. So they went around. When they were driving for only 1 minute, you know what they saw in the middle of the road? It was a bag of hamburger buns, and it hadn't been opened. It looked like it was fresh from the store. It was a bit dusty on the outside because it had fallen in the dirt on the road. Stop the car, Daddy said. Daddy went out and picked up the hamburger buns and said, well, Gordy, it looks like God has given you part of a picnic, but not all of it. It was the strangest thing Daddy had ever seen. The bag of hamburger buns in the middle of the road. Daddy looked ahead of the car and said, wait a second. Hang on, let me walk up there a ways. There's something else in the middle of the road.
Oh.
As Daddy walked up, there was a bag full of fruit. Yeah, some of it was a little bit bruised. They were apples and oranges and pears. And there were also carrots and celery sticks inside of it that had been chopped up. "Somebody's prepared these," he said. "Look, and they're all nicely sealed in a plastic bag as well. Well, Gordy, you can have some of a picnic. Hamburger buns and fruit. You want a hamburger? A fruit hamburger?" Gordy laughed and said, "No." That doesn't really work, does it? They got in the car and they kept driving. The next thing they saw was a whole ice chest in the middle of the road, tipped over, and the lid was halfway open. The ice was leaking out of it, and Danny was shocked. He hopped out to see what was in it. The ice chest was full of cooked chicken, hamburgers, some cups, water, juice, and all sorts of other things. And there were even ice lollies in it, but they were halfway melted. "Quick," said Daddy. "Here, eat the ice lollies first. They're melting." God had actually given them a picnic. They didn't know where it came from, but they were all thanking God for their picnic. And they sat in the car. They had burgers and fruit and drinks and everything. They turned their car back around after they finished eating and went back and did more hiking until the evening when they went home. Gordy said, "I don't know how all that happened, but God answered our prayer and gave us a picnic."
If you're so sure it may happen.
Yes, you have to believe in your heart God will do it. And then that's when amazing things happen. A few days later, Daddy was talking to one of his friends, and his friends had a son and daughter that were hiking around the same mountain that Gordy's family were. "Oh," said Daddy, "you'll never believe what happened to us." And Daddy told his friend the whole story. Oh. Daddy's friend said, "Wait a second, just sit here for a second. George, come here." George was Daddy's, was the friend's son. "Did you guys go hiking on that mountain that day?" "Yes," said George. "What happened? You took a whole picnic up that mountain. Did you eat it?" "Oh," said George, "I completely forgot about it. We were going to have a picnic, and then we were having so much fun, we decided to drive back down the mountain and eat at a restaurant instead. I completely even forgot that we had a picnic in the back of the car." George said, "And yes, and the car was tied shut because it was too big to fit in the back. That ice chest made the boot of the car stick up a little bit. We had tied it with string. And we noticed, actually, when we got down to the restaurant that the string was loose. So we just opened it up and shut the boot properly and went into the restaurant." George thought, "Actually, the whole picnic is gone. It must have bounced out of the back of the car when we were driving, and we didn't even know it."
"How can that happen when the car is closed?"
"It wasn't closed. It was only tied with a loose string. It wasn't shut all the way. The boot wasn't shut."
"You can't do that. You have to walk it."
"Yeah, and it just was bouncing and wiggling, and things just kept falling out, and then all of their picnic fell out." Daddy said, "Well, you won't believe that. How God provides." Daddy's friend laughed and said, "Yes, how God provides. God gave you our picnic because you prayed for it. Probably if your son hadn't prayed that God would give him a picnic, it would still be in the back of the car just getting spoiled and rotten because my son forgot it was there." They both laughed and they both thanked God and they were both singing praises to God for his goodness. Gordy had prayed, God had answered. And this man was so happy about the whole situation. God provides in wonderful ways, and sometimes surprising ways. God loves to surprise us. But we need to be able to be quiet and listen to God, pray and believe that something amazing will happen. Jesus said, if you believe, actually it's not Jesus, it's in the book of James. If you believe in your heart and you do not doubt, whatever you pray for will happen. It might not happen straight away, but it will happen if it's God's will. And that was Gordy and the Impossible Situation.